The push to prohibit discriminatory practices on the basis of sexual orientation and gender identity expression, or SOGI, faces tough opposition in the Philippine Congress. At the Senate, the move to pass the SOGI bill has been stalled. That's after Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva moved to refer the bill to the Committee on Rules for further study, which he chairs. He argues religious groups were not consulted about the bill. Over at the lower chamber, the senator's father, Sibak Representative Eddie Villanueva, sought to defer the hearing on the measure, calling it illegal. All right, for a discussion on this, we're now joined by Bataan Representative Geraldine Roman. She's the chairperson of the House Committee on Women and Gender Equality. Congresswoman Roman, thank you for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Magandang tanghali kanina, magandang tanghali po sa ating mga nakikinig.
Right, mamaya-maya po pag-uusapan natin kung ano mismo ang nangyari doon sa hearing ninyo kahapon. But first, as it stands, what is the status of the SOGI bill at the lower house?
We were tackling for the first time in the Committee on Women and Gender Equality the anti-discrimination bill. So relatively, it's late compared to the status of the bill in the upper house. But we are working on it.
All right. Now, talk to us about what happened yesterday. You were called tyrannical for standing your ground. Tell us how it all went down.
Mm-hmm. Well, in my opinion, the comments were out of place. The comments made by Representative Eddie Villanueva, as well as the comments made by Representative Benny Abante. I am the chairperson of the Committee on Women and Gender Equality. We scheduled the meeting for yesterday and we got the clearance from the Committee on Rules. Mm. It seems that all of a sudden they barge into the meeting demanding that we suspend the meeting. Now, who are they to suspend the meeting? Only the Rules Committee can stop us from holding the committee. And they were alleging so many reasons such as forum shopping and that it would create a precedent. Well, you know, he was barking at the wrong tree. Those issues had to be settled at the Committee on Rules, not in our very own committee. Now, in the exercise of my prerogatives as chairperson of the Committee on Women and Gender Equality, I decided to push through with a meeting, at which point he called me tyrannical. Really, it's out of place. And it's really a demonstration of patriarchy and I don't know, lack of good manners and right conduct. That is my opinion.
Were you forum shopping? Because as you said, that was one of the accusations hurled at you yesterday.
Forum shopping, because he said that there is a similar bill being heard already at the Committee on Human Rights, which is chaired by Representative Benny Abante, his close ally in the fight to oppose the SOGI equality bill. Now, historically, there have always been two types of anti-discrimination bills since the 10th, 11th, 12th, and 13th Congress onwards. And these bills have been handled in the committees that are handling them right now. The Comprehensive Anti-Discrimination Bill has historically been handled in the Committee on Human Rights, while the Anti-Discrimination Bill based on SOGI has always been handled by the Committee on Women and Gender Equality, because we are dealing here with gender-based discrimination. Now, all of a sudden, they come in so enlightened and asking us to stop the meeting. What right have they? Really? For me, this is simple delaying tactic. And you know what? Come to think of it, people resort to delaying tactics when they lack valid arguments. All I'm calling for is an intelligent, open discussion at the committee level. Now, if you try to stop even this discussion, what does it say of you? It says that you are desperate. I'm reading. There should be reason to be desperate on their part, because we have the numbers in Congress and even in the Senate. Because 19 out of 24 senators signed the bill filed by Senator Risa Ontiveros. And most of my colleagues are very supportive of the SOGI equality bill. Because it's been a long discussion already, Carmina. 23 years of formal discussions in the Senate and in the House. And that long period of time has served to open our minds to what the bill is and what it is not. Mm. So my colleagues already know that it is not the same-sex marriage bill. It is not the gender recognition bill. It does not step on your religious freedom. In fact, it's very respectful. All it seeks to do is to protect Filipinos from discrimination based on their sexual orientation and gender identity and expression. So I'm making a call, really, to our senators. Mga senador po kayo, mga matatalino kayo. Hayaan po ninyo ang open and intelligent discussion, whether at the committee level or at the floor. But please, do not use delaying tactics because it's so unbecoming.
Yeah, with what happened yesterday, Congresswoman, do you think that had less to do with the rules and the technicalities that they were saying and more to do really with their stand against the SOGI bill?
My God, I mean, like, for several Congresses already, these bills have been handled in the committees that they are in right now, namely the Committee on Human Rights for the Comprehensive Anti-Discrimination Bill and the Committee on Women and Gender Equality for the SOGI Equality Bill. Now they are questioning us after several batches of Congress. I mean, there is no basis for that. Are they to question the wisdom of their previous, of our predecessors, of the House leadership? Ano ba ito? Mas expert pa sila dun sa mga nakaraang kongreso? I mean, a little bit of humility. Pag-usapan na lang natin sa committee. At kami naman po, kahit tanungin nyo yung mga resource persons na kumakatawan dun sa mga grupo na kumukontra sa SOGI Equality Bill, tayo po ay nakikinig. Mag-alang po tayo. Merong free flow of discussion. Wala naman pong pumipigil. Sino ba ang pumipigil dito? Eh di sila. Nakakasamahan ko pa sa Kongreso at hindi ko talaga maunawaan kung saan sila nang gagaling. Ano ba kinatatakot nyo na pag-uusapan natin ito? Eh di ba nariyan tayo sa Kongreso para magkaroon ng malayang pagdidiskusyon at pag-uusap? Eh bakit nyo pinipigilan? Yun ang katanungan ko.
Well, if you ask Congressman Eddie Villanueva, he's saying that the anti-discrimination bill is a more comprehensive one. How does it differ from the SOGI bill?
Well, it is a more comprehensive one. It covers sex, age, civil status, health status, physical appearance, ethnicity, religion, and sexual orientation and gender identity and expression. But let me tell you one thing, Carnina. The problem is, doon sa Committee ng Human Rights, lahat na mga binanggit kong possible motives for discrimination or what we call protected attributes ay kinikilala nila except sexual orientation and gender identity and expression. Paano naman, saan naman namin ilulugar ang aming sarili? Imantakin mo. Pag naroon sila sa Committee on Women and Gender Equality, sasabihin nila, huwag nang pag-usapan ng SOGI Equality Bill dahil meron namang Comprehensive Anti-Discrimination Bill. Pagpupunta naman ako doon sa Committee on Human Rights para pag-usapan yung Comprehensive Anti-Discrimination Bill, gusto nilang tanggalin bilang protected attribute or possible motive for discrimination ang sexual orientation and gender identity expression. Saan kami ilulugar? Ang sakit nga karinina eh. Just the very act of singling out SOGI as a protected attribute is an act of discrimination by itself. Para bang sinasabi nila, oo, masama mag-discriminate sa mga senior citizens dahil on the basis of age yan. Mag-discriminate sa mga indigenous peoples because oh, that's on the basis of ethnicity. Or against people who belong to other religions because that's on the basis of religion. But yes, it's okay to discriminate against the members of the LGBT community because they are LGBTQ. Now, what do you call that? That's plain and simple discrimination. And that's being practiced in the Committee of Human Rights, which is really an irony, a great irony.
I was going to say, very ironic that this whole discussion that we're having right now only really shows why the SOGI bill is needed. It's the perfect example.
Yes, it's the perfect example. And you know what, Carmina? At the local level, sa maraming LGUs sa ating bansa, a total of around 60 LGUs, whether cities, provinces, or municipalities, have already filed their own versions of the anti-discrimination bill. And to my knowledge, the sun continues to shine over these provinces and these LGUs and these cities. And what you have are happy citizens who feel secure because they know that if they are qualified to work, kahit may LGBT sila, ay matatanggap sila sa trabaho. They know na kahit LGBT sila, kung meron naman silang qualifications, maaari sila mag-aral. Makakatanggap sila ng serbisyo mula sa pamahalaan ng walang diskriminasyon. Now, the question is, if we allow it at the local level, what is stopping us from passing a similar law on the national level? What is stopping us?
So give me the answer. I mean, you've been working on this for quite a long time already. As you said, it's been more than two decades. What would make this see the light of day?
What will make it see the light of day? Pag pinag-usapan na yan sa komite at pinag-usapan na yan sa plenaryo or sa floor, sa isang pamamaraang malaya, makikita at mabubuksan ang mga mata ng ating mga senador. At bukas naman talaga eh, kaya lang pinipigilan eh. Sinasamantala ang mga internal rules sa aking humble opinion. At pag nagkaroon ng malayang diskusyon, ay mas malalong maninindigan ang ating mga senador, ang ating mga representatives para sa equality, para sa non-discrimination, para sa human rights and human dignity ng lahat ng Pilipino, maging LGBT man o hindi.
But with what the Villanuevas did yesterday, Congresswoman Roman, what does that tell you about how and where this is going?
Well, it simply tells me that they're very desperate because they know they don't have the numbers.
And we're going to have to leave it at that. Congresswoman Geraldine Roman there, chairperson of the House Committee on Women and Gender Equality. Thanks for taking our call.